Assalamualaikum. So today we are going to cover the last type of lithography, which is ion beam lithography. So here's the content of the lecture today. So ion beam lithography is a scanning a focus beam of iron into a pattern across the surface in order to create very small structure, for example the integrated circuit or other nanostructure. So the difference between ion beam lithography from the other lithography is using ion instead of using X-ray, UV or electron. So why ion beam lithography? So ion beam have a heavy mass compared to the electrons. So this offer the higher resolution pattern rather than the UV and X-ray or electron beam because this heavy particle have more momentum and smaller wavelength, so then there will be almost no diffraction in the process. So the momentum also reduce the scattering in the target, if you can remember the one that we cover in the electron beam lithography, where the disadvantage of the electron beam lithography is the scattering. Okay, so we can reduce the scattering in the ion beam lithography. Okay, so there are also a reduced potential radiation effect to sensitive underlying structure compared to X-ray and e-beam lithography. So the comparison between the lithographies is shown in the figure below. As for example, for A is optical lithography. If you can see the penetration, the diameter area being affected is bigger compared to the other part. Second one is electron beam lithography. We can see there are scattering of electrons, secondary electron in the substrate. The third one is X-ray lithography. It is sharper, but due to the mass and also the diffraction, so there are compared to the ion beam lithography, ion beam is better. If you can see on the last picture, the penetration is less compared to the other type of lithography, and then it's sharper, there is less diffraction, and the end product will be much more accurate. So there are two ion sources. One is gas discharge ion source, another one is liquid metal ion source or LMIS. So in gas discharge ion source, ion are created by plasma or by electric discharge, and this one is used in high energy accelerator and ion implanter for semiconductor manufacture. And for the liquid metal ion source, it's operated by desorption of metal ion from liquid metal under a strong electrical field. So this one we're going to look in detail. So let us see the gas ion sources. First, the gas will be supplied into the chamber, and then there's input power here. So in here, what happen is the positive ion will be separated, and then will go through the ion extraction region. So this one, all the positive ion will go to through the chamber. So then it can produce the process. Okay. So potential place at extraction region, remove ion from the chamber. So this area is where the positive ion is going to be removed. Okay. So the gas sources such as hydrogen, helium, argon, and etc. Usually the inert gas. Now let us look into the ion metal sources. So the ion metal sources has small n radius emitter. So if you can see here, this is the ion emitter. Okay, so where ion come out from this one, so it has a n radius emitter and then coated with metal having a high surface tension and low vapor pressure. So the emitter is heated to the melting point of the metal. So this one, this emitter will be heated to the temperature of the metal inside here. Okay, so then positive voltage will be supplied to this area, and then if we go if we magnify this tip at this one, okay, if you can see the liquid melted liquid metal will go through this tip, okay, this small tip, and then the apex of the liquid cone is drawn to an end radius to small that high electric field. So this one they have a high electric field, this part, okay, and then cause ion to begin to form, okay, so then the ion will start to form here and then come out through this tip, okay. So the tip here, the radius of this one is around 5 nanometer. So the metal that source of metal used for this liquid is usually gallium GA or gold with the gold silicon alloy or gold silicon barium alloy used for this type of lithography, because this source of metal can supply lighter mass ion compared to the others. Ion beam lithography have two techniques. One is focused ion beam lithography, where direct writing of the ion on the substrate can be performed. Another one is mass ion beam lithography, where the beam pass through the ion transparent membrane. So the pattern with the absorber material is positioned close to the coated substrate, so that then the printing can be performed. So in this process, resist that usually used is PMMA, is the most common one. Other than that, polybutene-1-sulfone or polytrifluorethyl A chloroacrylate is used. So the features is in this process, penetration of the particle beam is small compared to the electron beam or other process. So in this process, reduced blurring resulting from beam scattering can be achieved. So reduced proximity effect, increased localization and precision, so the product produced is much more accurate and less scattering and also diffraction. So focused ion beam FIB lithography is an ion beam scan across the substrate surface and exposed electron sensitive coating. So this one is like a writing using a pen on a paper. So it's a direct drawing on the substrate. So a grid of pixel is superimposed on the substrate surface. So each pixel will have a unique address. So the pattern data is transferred to the controlling computer, which then direct the electron beam to realize the pattern on the substrate pixel by pixel. So there are two types of focused ion beam lithography. One is low acceleration voltage, which is below 50 kilovolt column without mass separation. So this one is designed for application, for example, mass repair, microcircuit modification, and scanning ion microscope using gallium LMIS. So high accelerated voltage is more than 100 kV. Columns with mass separators, so that's the different. And then designed for applications such as ion implantation and lithography with alloy LMIS. Here is the diagram for low voltage column with mass without mass separator. So if you can see in here, the top part is the where the liquid gallium. So if you can remember previously on the metal ion source, okay, so in here there'll be gallium liquid metal, okay, so then the ion will come out from this area. So then there'll be extraction of electrodes where only the positive ion going through this surface, okay. So then if you can see here, there is no mass separator, so you will see the difference in the next slide. Okay, so and then it goes direct, it will accelerate the electron, the ion in the accelerating lens electrodes, and then it goes directly to the target. And this picture shows the high acceleration voltage column with mass separation. So in this ion from the LMIS on the top here, so focus to across at the intermediate aperture by the condensed lens. So see, this is the condensed lens, okay. So Then cross electric magnetic, or we can simplify it by EXB. Okay, field act as a velocity filter. So then effectively separating the ions as species by mass. So this area they will filter the ion. Okay, so the EXB filter is then adjust to allow only the desired ion species to pass through the intermediate aperture and rest of optical column. So the objective lens then focus the mass selected beam onto the target. So compared to previous one, there are mass separator in this diagram. Mass ion beam lithography is quite similar to the proximity printing, if you can remember, because this part they have the stencil over here, the stencil mask, and it is close to the substrate, is placed close to substrate. So in mass ion beam lithography, a high resolution pattern replication process that offer high throughput capability with sub micro resolution. So meaning that the ion is coming out over here. Okay, this is ion source. It goes to the EB mass separation unit like the previous one, and then the ion will go like this one, not focus only on one source, so on the tips of the steel of the ion emitter. So this one, there are a lot of ion coming out from here. Okay, and then it goes through the mask, and then it will start the printing on the substrate. So here are some advantages of the ion beam lithography. The first one is it is computer controlled beam. So this one, you can control the beam using the computer. No mask is needed. It can also produce sub micron features. Lasers are more sensitive than electron beam lasers, therefore the product produced will be better. And then diffraction effect also minimized because of the wavelength of the ion. And then less backscattering occurs, and also higher in resolution. So although there are a lot of advantages for ion beam lithography, there are also disadvantages. For example, we need a very reliable ion source in order to make sure the operation is good. And then swelling also might occur when developing negative ion beam resist, because and this one will limit the resolution of the final product. And then it is more expensive compared to the light lithography system, and it also slower compared to the light lithography system, and it require tri-level processing in order to finish the product. So that's the end of lithography topics with ion beam lithography. So we are going to continue with the next topics after the exam. Thank you for listening. Assalamualaikum.